Hey there, Cosmic Warriors, and welcome back to another video. Okay, so in today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the revolution and the rebellion of Uranus in the fourth house slash Aquarius ruling the fourth house individuals. Now, this video may also resonate if you have an Aquarius moon, so I just want to mention that first and foremost. But before we do jump into the video today, make sure that you like this video if you like it. Also, make sure to subscribe if you have not already and click that little bell in order to keep yourself notified with more astrology videos from myself. And I also want to know in the comment section, how do you rebel against authority? How do you rebel against authority? And as well, if you do want to know more information all about your Uranus sign and your Uranus house, along with your Aquarius house and your 11th house within your birth chart, then I have created an Aquarius season slash archetype ebook. So what I am going to do is I'm going to provide a link to that ebook in the description box below so that you can pick up your copy today if you would like. All right, so with all those introductions out of the way, Aquarius ruling the fourth house and Uranus within the fourth house, let's do this. Uranus in your fourth house or Aquarius ruling your fourth house and also your moon in Aquarius here, then you're most likely going to be an individual who learned from your family how to rebel and how to essentially break out and be your own individual, how to be your own person. However, this might not have been an easy or pleasant process because it's something that might have being forced onto you, whether that be subconsciously or unknowingly, meaning that your rebellion lies in events that really went on within the very walls of where you were supposed to feel safe and protected from childhood, so from quite a young age. And what I further mean by this is that, for example, you could have grown up in a pretty chaotic, disruptive, and erratic family setting. And it was this particular family environment that led to your rebellion as a way to protect yourself and keep yourself safe. So, some examples as to how this might have played out include breakups between family members, sudden changes being imposed within the home that made you feel uncomfortable, abnormal behaviors and attitudes from loved ones, feeling like an outcast or as the black sheep within your family dynamics, or being raised in a family home where you never felt heard, understood, or emotionally supported. It was these types of events that might have actually pushed on you strongly here to break out and break free. And so you rebelled against your family. Maybe you even refused to listen to family members because you think you know best, or perhaps you learned from your family how to be the master of refusing to listen to others because they made it out that they knew best. And so perhaps your whole family dynamics lies in being strong-minded and fixed. Then again, this could be a situation where you felt like you needed to change your outlook towards what family actually means. You sort of were forced to forge your own path, and so you developed a great deal of independence due to your living or family situation. Therefore, as you go to establish a home for yourself one day, you may strongly seek freedom and space within that particular home. Maybe you want to make your own decisions over how to decorate the home, for example, or maybe you want to feel like you have plenty of room to breathe within that home. You might have even all of these really unconventional and insane and wacky ideas as to how you want to arrange or how you want to create that home. And once you have settled into a particular place of your own, you might then often rearrange the furniture or switch up how everything is laid out. You might have little quirky or unusual ways that you do things within your home, and you're not going to really appreciate it if others try to tell you otherwise on how to arrange things or how to act within your home. And if people try to tell you, you might not overly care. And you might even deliberately change your home interior so that it doesn't look like other people's. Basically suggesting that you want your originality and your creative genius to come out within your living situation. Now, in terms of potentially having a family of your own one day, you might do this slightly differently in comparison to how others do it. You may be the type of person, for example, who chooses to adopt, or you might prefer not to have any children of your own and decide to be a step-parent to your partner's children. So whether or not you decide to have children or not have children, you might give your family and loved ones plenty of space and freedom. And you also might raise your children completely different in comparison to how you were raised by your own parents. Now, in terms of emotional comfort and support here, well, maybe these things were somewhat lacking from your childhood upbringing, resulting in you finding it somewhat difficult to show affection and personal receptivity. Though that doesn't mean that you don't feel or love, nor does it mean that you don't care. It's just that growing up, you maybe didn't feel like you could let out your emotions very well within your family unit. So if you were not really taught these things of how to show affection, it can be hard then to show affection yourself later on in life. Then again, this could be that you just have your own way of showing affection. Perhaps it was here, Uranus in the fourth house, Aquarius ruling the fourth house, that there was just so much going on at once with everybody else within your home environment that your own personal needs were not met. So essentially, you had to learn how to fulfill these personal needs yourself, resulting in you internally being a highly independent person. Someone who finds it really, really difficult to take order from other people, and also someone who can feel highly misunderstood in terms of how you show affection. Then again, someone who also might quite honestly be a little bit challenging to live with. Why? Because it's these same instinctive subconscious attitudes and drives that you might bring into your own family one day, such as refusing to listen or obey to your spouse, debating with your children to get your point across until you're just blue in the face, or quite possibly neglecting your family roots altogether and instead coming up with an entirely new structure. You might quite literally turn your back on your family or on the traditions that your family followed, and by doing this, well, it could possibly result in your family being a little bit upset with you, but for the most part, I do think that your family accepts this because, well, they have no other choice but to accept these things about you because, hey, you're going to be strong-willed and minded towards them anyway. So it's just very unlikely that you're going to change your mind or listen to your family's opinion. Another possibility, though, is that you've changed locations or relocated quite a bit throughout your life, Uranus in the fourth house, Aquarius ruling the fourth house. Maybe you can get quite restless being in one place for too long, or maybe you have been forced to move due to sudden circumstances. So for example, perhaps you've been in a living situation where you have lived with someone else or a few different people, but then a sudden breakup or disruption causes you to move. Could be due to an actual breakup here, or due to financial discrepancies, or perhaps due to you literally needing to move because of how stuck, confined, and trapped you felt. Suffocating. So in this respect, if you do live with someone that makes you feel controlled or smothered, you will most likely rebel and get the hell out of there. No turning back. Though, speaking of turning back, you might be the type of person who doesn't really enjoy or like looking back at the past. What's in the past is in the past, and it can stay there according to you. So in this way, you might not be the most sentimental person. You may be someone who throws things away very easily rather than savoring them. Or you might catch yourself on whenever you're reflecting upon the past and then you cut off the memory like that. Though I still think that this is more so if it's a memory that brings you pain or sadness, or maybe even jealousy and anger, which, by the way, you might often detach yourself from uncomfortable memories or past experiences. It could very well be that you come from a somewhat broken family. So, I mean, separation, instability, unreliability, inconsistency. So, I think with this, you kind of had to detach as a way to protect yourself, like I said at the beginning. And so in this respect, I think you're someone who is more focused on your future memories and all the experiences that you have to look forward to and enjoy. Though, having said that, at the same time, I think these things can depend on your current living situation. See, it could very well be here, Uranus in the fourth house, Aquarius in the fourth house, that you carry around deep feelings of not belonging. And so you might find it so incredibly difficult to set up roots somewhere. And even when you do, well, you might feel out of touch or distant from the environment itself. And so with this can come panic, worry, stress, anxiety, especially if you possess a real deep inner need and desire to belong somewhere, yet you struggle to do so. But on the other hand, I think that when you do find a particular living situation where your inner rebellion is embraced, you will feel at home. So this could quite literally be you living on your own or with a cat or dog, but it's within this particular place that your freak flag is allowed to fly. Or this could be you living with a particular spouse or some friends or even having a family, but within that particular unit, whatever the case may be, you feel accepted, you feel understood, you feel heard by this person or by these individuals. Also further suggesting that you seek after a feeling of community when it comes to your living situation. An environment where you are free to be yourself. Somewhere where there is fairness and equality and understanding between all parties. And it could very well be that it's these things that you strive for when it comes to home and family, especially if it was that these qualities were lacking during your younger years. And if these needs are not fulfilled, you might not feel emotionally satisfied. It's basically you who may carry around this subconscious notion that everything is going to come crashing down, that it's all gonna just end with an explosion at any point. And so you may possibly self-sabotage, but yet it's these things that can be stemming from the explosions and the disruptions that you experience from a very young age. And so you may struggle to feel settled or emotionally content. But perhaps for you, Uranus in the fourth house, Aquarius ruling the fourth house, you're learning how to live with these unsettling and uncomfortable feelings more effectively. Ultimately, your rebellion and your revolution comes from you distancing yourself from the past in order to forge your own path towards a better future within your home environment. And I think that a lot of your emotional security and your feelings of belonging, they lie in you finding a sense of community at home, somewhere where you are free to be your quirky and weird self. Okay then, cosmic warriors, so that concludes the revolution and rebellion of Uranus in the fourth house slash Aquarius ruling the fourth house, and for you Aquarius moons as well out there. Again, make sure that you like this video if you liked it, and make sure to comment in the comment section how you rebel against authority, and also if you have any of these placements, let us know what you thought of the video there. So with that then, thank you so much for watching, thank you for subscribing, and of course if you would like to see more videos from myself and you have not yet subscribed, then make sure you do so, and also click that bell button to keep yourself notified. But with all that being said, I will catch you on the next video on Hannah's Elsewhere. Bye!